Encourage my soul and let us journey on. For the night is dark and I am far from home. Thanks be to God, the morning light appears. The storm is passing over. The storm is passing over. The storm is passing over. Hallelujah.
What's going on, true believers? It's the One Over Show. You know Ken Spence in the building. Hope you're having a blessed one. Hope it's a blessed day. It's morning on my side, but I'm not sure what time of day it is for you. But I know God is doing some great and magnificent things, not just in my life. He's doing it in your life. He's doing it in the world. It seems like it's a downtime right now. It seems like it's a bad time right now. But trust me, as the Bible says, joy comes in the morning. You have to realize that in order for you to get to the rainbow, to see the beautiful rainbow, you have to endure some rain. Some dark clouds. In order for you to get a testimony, you have to go through a test. That's cliche, but that cliche is true. So I just want to encourage you. Hopefully you recognize that God is good. Hopefully you're studying your Bible on a regular basis so you understand God is good. So let me talk to you for a moment. Part two in this series. We're actually talking about in the last video that we did, in this two-video series, if you will, we talked about coming out of yourself, releasing yourself into a song. And I want to talk to you about the difference between releasing yourself and getting into a performance. Now, this is touchy for a lot of people, because some people, when they see you kind of release and come out of yourself, they'll kind of look and say, oh, he ain't doing nothing but performing, and they have something bad to say. The truth of the matter is, your general life is evident of what it is. There are some song leaders, some great song leaders that we have within our brotherhood. We've had many song leaders, and this has just been consistent throughout time as we go back. I was looking at a Marshall Keeble story, and there was song leaders that would travel with him, but they were preachers as well, and they would sing so powerfully, and people, man, that's just a powerful song leader, kind of in the way. And as you look at time progresses and it moves forward and moves on, and you keep seeing these things, and you say, man, that's interesting, because I never expected that. And so here it is. So today we have the same types of song leaders that are just powerful, that are just great song leaders. And unfortunately, many of them are very egotistical. And because they're very egotistical, when they go to lead a song, sometimes they'll come out of themselves. And really, it's not... You see the ego. You don't see the spirit. You don't see grace. You see the ego. You see some individuals that love to show off, and they'll tell you they love to show off, and they show off in a number of ways. And because they show off in a number of ways, people, when they might do a great job, but to them it's a performance. There was a brother who kept coming to me and asked me to keep singing a song. No, bro. Yo, so when you get there, look, you got to sing this song. And I'm like, this is not a performance, dude. Eventually it came to that point I had to say straight up, dude, this is not a performance. Because the way I lead is that I have to feel the congregation. And if the spirit is moving towards a particular, if the message is moving there and the spirit is in a great fashion, then perhaps we might do this particular song to continue to lead them into a Godward focus. I can't just get up there, I'm going to sing this song because it's, no. It's about connecting the dots. It's not about making sure I'm in the number one spot. It's not that. I didn't even intend for that to rhyme. Well, I kind of sort of did. But it's not about the performance. It's about the connection. And truth be told, people will see the connection in you. They'll look at you and be like, oh, man, there's a connection. Or they'll look at you and be like, oh, man, well, that was a good job. And tell them, that boy, that was a good job. But like, there are some individuals I know that do a great job leading song service. But the reaction happened recently. I witnessed it. And I was looking at two particular song leaders, and you can tell that they were putting their heart into it. And the congregation responded in tune because they were putting their heart into it to raise praise to heaven. However, the song leader that came, and well, the reaction was the congregation, they in turn raised praise to heaven. And it was just a beautiful thing that took place. But then another song leader got up there. A very experienced song leader got up there. And he raised praise toward heaven. But he got so into the performance, I was shocked when I saw the reaction of the congregation. That the reaction was, here he go. And I'm just like, he wasn't even at his home congregation. I'm like, hold on, how'd that happen? How did they pick up on, and this is a while back, I said recently. Well, recently it happened, but this was a while back. The story I'm talking about is a while back. So it's like, they picked up on his spirit. They picked up on the sincerity of who he was. And that's how they were able to decipher whether or not this was a show, or this was to praise God. Song leader, I want to charge you. Don't focus on yourself. There are two things that we said we're talking about today, and they are separating them. First, raising praise toward heaven versus or releasing yourself in raising praise toward heaven. And the second is getting into a performance. I want to charge you to focus upward and not to focus inward. Reason I did that, reason I say that to you is because if you're focused inward on what you could do, man, I could really freak this song out, man, if I just got up there. Oh, I want to see him. Upon his face. Like, we got you. Well, it's one of the things, let me not change subject, but it's imperative for you not to focus on what you can do, but to focus on what God can do and what God has done. This is why Bible study is so important. I've said it again. Bible study is so key, because when you study the word is when it all comes together, is when it all makes sense, it's when everything is on point. It's the same reason why you have experienced song leaders that are very gifted. Said his name 1,000 times, I'm going to say it again. When I examine, I use two brothers that are really excellent song leaders. I'm about to say Curtis Mayfield, Chester Mayfield, from the Southside Church of Christ in Durham, North Carolina, where Brother Will Stevens is the minister, and Brother Chris Turner, minister of the Sunset Road Church of Christ in Burlington, New Jersey. And the reason I'm going to use them, well, one, they're friends, they know each other, they've been singing together for years. But examining these men, when they get into a song and they get on fire, Humble is the Way. I'll put the channel right here. Go there and search the best of Chester Mayfield and search the best of Chris Turner. There's actually three videos that are best of Chris Turner, but just pick one of them and just examine them. Someone could look and say, man, they showing off. But even though it's video, you can look and you can see these brothers are really just all about praising God. You see the spirituality within them because they're closer to God's word. At one point in time, they both were just song leaders. Well, If I'm correct, I believe Brother Mayfield, he's a deacon down there in Southside. And of course, Brother Turner now, he's a minister up here at Sunset. So it's like, you look and you see it, it's like, well, hold up. That couldn't happen just because they could sing good. They had to be about God's business. They had to be in that word. However, sometimes you'll see a song leader that, unfortunately, that's all she wrote. And there's nothing wrong with being just a song leader. There is blessings in being a great song leader. But when this becomes more focused on what you can do, then you're always going to be focused on what you can do. And in some cases, that might mean just focusing on the check you get once you go sing somewhere. I said it. I'm a preacher and I ain't scared to say what's real. That is literally the way it is. There are some song leaders that love them dearly. And some song leaders, when they get a check, they really are spiritual individuals. You can see it on them. They're spiritual individuals. And some of them, actually, some people may talk, oh, well, you know, all they're doing is showing off. Like Dorian Paul Williams, great man of God, knows God's word. He's in God's word. Sat in a workshop he did at a lectureship 2 years ago. And just an excellent brother, got cool with him, got his number. Me and him, well, we don't talk often. We talk from here, from time to time, many times when we see each other, but a great man of God. And you know what? His manner of singing, because he was a big singer with the Gap Band and the Wilsons, and just a fantastic singer. And he brings his talent from out in the world and brings it to the church. And there are some things that, no, they won't change. Some things that will remain the same because he is who he is. But there's nothing wrong with him putting it, being just a good brother, and you can see the spirit on him. However, there are some people that might misinterpret it because of his mannerisms and how he conducts himself. But he's a brother that is not afraid to worship God, and I respect that. And love him for it. And Paul, if you're watching, I love you, bro. But there are some song leaders. Now I won't say any names. But there are some song leaders that they show up. Oh, I got my check? Cool. This is gonna be a beautiful service. Dum, 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 dum. Look, the reason I did that is just because that's exactly what it is. It's a performance for them. Yo, I'm going on tour. I'm gonna be down here. And it's like, my goodness. It's not to say that all they're focused on is going from congregation to congregation singing. It's to say that they're there just for a check. That this is all about them. It has nothing to do with God. Now, here's the truth of the matter. There are some song leaders that are just song leaders, the great ministers of music. They actually do go from congregation to congregation because a lot of congregations call them. I can think of like Jeff and Jesse Mara, both of those brothers. They travel independently of each other, unless they're performing with Strength Company, which is their which everybody knows Strength Company. If you don't know Strength Company, you need to get yourself straight. Anyway, then there's Hamilton Landrum. Because people call them, Malcolm Himes, people call them all the time. So it's like, man, I'm trying to set my schedule. Please, I need to be at my home congregation so I ain't got to fill out a visitor's card. So it's understand. There are some song leaders that are great song leaders, great ministers of music, and that's what they do. But there are some, and unfortunately, they're regionalized. They're localized. They'll go to congregations in this specific area, and when they walk in, they feel like they're $1 million. They feel like they're special. They feel like they're something greater than God is. You can't focus on what you can do. You have to focus on what God can do, what God has done, what God is doing. And that'll show people. They'll see it on you. And they'll be like, my brother got a spirit on him. My brother got God's spirit on him. And you know what? Sometimes some things hit you and you might start crying. Look, if you ask anybody in Philadelphia, as Ken Spence ever started crying while he led a song service there, they be like, uh-huh, cry, baby. It's just, Spence's, we do that. But I mean, it's just one of them things that when you really are in tune with what the word says, with what God has done, with what God is doing, what God's about to do, Now, we don't know what God's about to do, but when you know God is, no matter what God is going to do, it's going to be something good. Even if it's not exactly how you thought it was, you know. And when you hear the words, they just trigger God. You just know. You just have that deeper, that in-tune relationship with God. Everything is Godward in focus. Nothing is on you. Everything is there. Well, then you'll become a better song leader. It'll be easier to release. And it'll be easier to, or it will be blatantly showing that it's not a performance. So, song leader, I encourage you in all that you do. Pray that God bless you, God keep you, and that Lord willing, I will see you at the next video. And any questions, any comments, anything, you can email me. That information is in the description box. You can comment on the video. Please like this video, share this video, subscribe to the channel if you're not subscribed. There are a ton of other videos you can view as well. God bless you, God keep you, and Lord willing, I will see you at the next video.